नमस्कार, मैं हूं देवांजलि मोइत्रा। सोशल मीडिया के सिकंदर माने जाने वाले तेजिंदर पाल सिंह बग्गा अगर किसी के पीछे पड़ जाते हैं तो फिर उसके पीछे पूरा सोशल मीडिया पड़ जाता है। पूर्व कांग्रेस अध्यक्ष राहुल गांधी से लेकर ममता बनर्जी जैसे नेताओं के खिलाफ सोशल मीडिया पर अभियान छेड़ने वाले बीजेपी के तेज तर्रार युवा नेता तेजिंदर पाल सिंह बग्गा आजकल पाकिस्तानी पीएम इमरान खान के पीछे पड़े हैं। मोदी सरकार ने जम्मू कश्मीर से जब से अनुच्छेद 370 हटाया है तभी से पूरे पाकिस्तान के साथ ही उसके प्रधानमंत्री इमरान खान भी अमेरिका से लेकर यूनाइटेड नेशन तक दौड़ भाग कर कश्मीर मसले पर दखल देने की मांग कर रहे हैं। लेकिन चारों तरफ बेचारे पाकिस्तान को नाकामी ही हाथ लग रही है, क्योंकि पूरा विश्व जानता है कि आतंकवाद को पालने पोसने वाला पाकिस्तान हमेशा झूठ ही बोलता है। दुनिया में अलग थलग पड़े पाकिस्तान को दिल्ली बीजेपी प्रवक्ता तेजिंदर पाल सिंह बग्गा ने ट्विटर पर ही ट्रोल कर दिया। बग्गा ने अपने ट्वीट में सिर्फ इतना पूछा कि अगर मैं नहीं कहूंगा तो आप इमरान खान को टैग कर ट्वीट नहीं करेंगे कि जो मोदी से डरता है यूएन करता है। बग्गा के पूछने भर की देरी थी कि ट्विटर पर हैशटैग जो मोदी से डरता है यूएन करता है ट्रेंड करने लगा। एक ट्विटर यूजर ने लिखा है, मोदी निडर है, वो सिर्फ पाकिस्तान और इमरान खान को ही नहीं दो करप्ट सेक्युलर्स को भी बुरे सपने नहीं दिखा रहे हैं। क्या आप सहमत हैं चिदंबरम? सात्विक सिन्हा नाम के ट्विटर यूजर ने लिखा है, आज की सच्चाई, आतंकवाद तहस नहस हो रहा है, कांग्रेस गहरे तनाव में है, कांग्रेस तहस नहस हो रही है, आतंकवादी गहरे तनाव में है। नितिन खोलिया नाम के ट्विटर यूजर ने लिखा है, इमरान खान अंकल आपसे नहीं हो पाएगा यार, आप जिस स्पीड से बोलिंग करोगे हम उसी स्पीड से सिक्स भी मारेंगे। एक यूजर ने इमरान खान का मीम पोस्ट किया है जिस पर लिखा है, पहले हम बहुत गरीब थे, फिर मोदी जी प्रधानमंत्री बन गए, अब हम भिखारी हैं। प्रकाश शेट्टी नाम के ट्विटर यूजर ने लिखा है, आई रीड इट एज जो मोदी से डरता है तुनक तुनक तुन करता है। एक ट्विटर यूजर ने लिखा है, 134 साल पुरानी कांग्रेस और 72 साल पुराने पाकिस्तान को 5 साल में ही भिखारी बना देने वाले मोदी जी को कुछ लोग राजनीति सिखा रहे हैं, हद है। बता दें, भारत के कश्मीर पर पाकिस्तान अपना दावा ठोकता रहा है। यही वजह है कि मोदी सरकार ने जब जम्मू कश्मीर से अनुच्छेद 370 हटाया तो पाकिस्तान बौखला गया और यूनाइटेड नेशन में कश्मीर मुद्दा उठाने की कोशिश करने लगा, जहां उसका साथ दिया चालू चीन ने। 16 अगस्त को चीन के आग्रह पर यूएनएससी अनौपचारिक बैठक पर सहमत हो गया, लेकिन बंद कमरे में हुई ये बैठक बेनतीजा या बगैर किसी बयान के समाप्त हो गई। वैश्विक संस्था की 15 देशों की सदस्यता वाली परिषद के ज्यादातर देशों ने इस बात पर जोर दिया कि ये भारत और पाक के बीच एक द्विपक्षीय मामला है।
Statements try to masquerade as the will of the international community. I thought I will come across to you too and explain our national position. And what is that? Our national position was and remains that matters related to Article 370 of the Indian Constitution are entirely an internal matter of India. These have no external ramifications. The recent decisions taken by the government of India and our legislative bodies are intended to ensure that good governance is promoted, socio-economic development is enhanced for our people in Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. You are aware this morning that the Chief Secretary of the State of the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir announced a whole set of measures that the government is undertaking to move towards normalcy. We are gratified that the Security Council, in its close consultations, appreciated these efforts, acknowledged them, and indicated that this is the direction in which they would like the international community to move. We are committed to gradually removing all restrictions You are aware of the timetable for that. Let me also tell you, since the changes internal to India have not made any difference to our external orientation, India remains committed to ensure that the situation there remains calm and peaceful. We are committed to all the agreements that we have signed on this issue. We note that there were some who tried to project an alarmist approach to the situation, which is far from the ground realities. Of particular concern is that one state is using terminology of jihad against and promoting violence in India, including by their leaders. Friends, violence is no solution to the problems that all of us face. We are committed to and inconsistent with our previous position that all issues between India and Pakistan, as well as India and any other country, will be resolved bilaterally, peacefully, and in a manner that behoves normal interstate relations between countries. We are saddened that terrorism is being fueled, language and incendiary talk of jihad is being mentioned by people who should know better. All of you are understanding of the situation here. I do not need to tell you what was the outcome of the close consultations. You will yourself know about it. We stand ready to continue our efforts towards peaceful resolution of all issues in an atmosphere free of terror and violence. And I'm ready, if any of you are willing to ask any questions, I will take. I understand there are many of you. This is my first time. So I said, please cut me slack.
Yes, I will.
Don't worry. I will. Please, I'll start with you.
Thank you.
Just relax. I will start with you. And I will answer five questions, which is five times more than both my predecessors who came here answered. Let's start you, since you are so excited.
No, I'm not excited. The only thing is the history is excited. There has been resolution on that disputed territory of Kashmir, and Article 370, fine. That could be an internal matter of
you. Thank you for accepting that.
No.
Thank you for accepting that. That
All
could
right,
be
sir.
Answered.
All right.
Thank you.
So Article 370 was enshrined in the Indian Constitution.
Thank you. By India.
Right. But the thing is, still the reality remains that how do you deal with the UN Security Council resolutions passed in 1947, 50, and then Shimla Agreement has also failed in bilateralism. Thank you.
Thank you. I understand your point. Your point is, how do we address this issue? The history is well known. I don't need to go back. Let us look at the last agreement that India and Pakistan signed. And that goes back to 1972. We are committed to that. And we hope Pakistan too is to try to address these issues in the manner that they have signed on to in a legally binding agreement. And we stand ready to address them in that context. We can go back in history, but every new agreement overtakes the past. So you are very well versed, my friend. Please appreciate that I started by saying we are committed to that agreement, and we hope Pakistan too is. Because if that is so, its action don't seem to be working out with what is in that agreement. Thank you. Yes, sir, I'll answer you, please. I will answer all my friends from
Thank
the South
you,
Asian continent.
Thank you.
Number two.
Okay, Ambassador, the fact remains, while you have said all these things that you're willing to talk and you're ready to talk, but what has happened? The fact remains, India has steadfastly refused to have
any meeting with Pakistan for one reason or another. It has been almost time immemorial. When are you going to sit down with Pakistan and have a meeting? Because, you know, and that's the reality.
Thank you.
Without
Can I
meeting,
answer?
Yes.
Can I answer the question? Let's be specific about questions. If your question is whether India and Pakistan have talked, let me tell you, I have been a member of many delegations to Islamabad. You're aware of that. I myself served as an Indian diplomat in Islamabad. So, please understand, there are normal diplomatic ways of dealing with countries when countries deal with each other. That's the way to do it. But using terror to try and push your goals is not the way that normal states behave in. No democracy will acknowledge or accept talks when terror thrives. Stop terror to start talks. Yes, sir.